Welcome to this Hints and Tips video. It's designed specifically to help you get more out of video interviews. Whether you're the interviewer or the interviewee, this is the video that you need to maximize your time and make it the most fun, effective, relaxed, and efficient experience possible for you both. My name's Lee Axon, and I am Digifin. This video is broken up into sections, so why don't we get straight on with tip number one. So the first tip that I have for you both is just to relax. The great news as an interviewee is this is not going live on Sky TV. It's not going to be going round the world as a Chris Hemsworth wanna. You've got time to plan and get your answers out one at a time. I would recommend you do turn up on time. You try and avoid any stressful situations on that day and you don't have any coffee. As the interviewer, just calm everybody down. Keep everybody nice and relaxed. Keep it fun. Keep it engaging. And maybe start off with just some simple fun questions. What's your favorite movie? Tell us about a memory which really made you happy as a child. Because what we want to do is we want to engage those happy flow chemicals in the brain, and we want to get the thoughts and the thought process aligned together, so when they do give you the answers, that they're not stuttering and it comes across nice and smooth. Tip number two is all about preparation as the interviewer. Please, as far in advance as you can, write down the questions that you'd like to ask. Once you've written them down, walk away from them. Come back to them. Make them better. Ask some friends and colleagues what would they say different. Because having something that you can visualize on the day and read off is going to be a lot easier and better for everybody rather than you trying to ad-lib. Tip number three builds upon tip number two. It's about the questions. Send them on, email them, pass them on, fax them, carrier pigeon. Make sure the interviewee has sight of these questions well in advance so they can practice the answers in time for the actual interview. As the interviewee, make sure you ask for the questions, and when you've got them, please read them and practice them and practice them and practice them. Tip number four is about sticking to the questions. You've went to the trouble of writing them down. You sent them to the interviewee, and the interviewee has practiced the questions. So changing them on the day is only going to cause confusion for the interviewee. So a great example would be if you've prepared the question, tell me why you chose to use Digifin to shoot your corporate video. That's the question you've sent out. That's the question you've practiced. What happens a lot of the time is they'll go, tell me why you chose to use Digifin to shoot your video. I mean, what was it about Digifin? What did you like? Like, have you known them for a long time? Has anybody else been involved? All of a sudden, you're battering their heads with multiple choice questions, and it throws off all the practice that they have had. It just makes the job harder for the interviewee to deliver you a nice, succinct, effective and efficient and concise answer. The next tip could be seen as a little bit controversial, but it's very important, certainly important from an editing perspective. It's try your best to be interviewing an expert in their field, but somebody who is very compatible with the camera in respect of vocal dialogue. It becomes an absolute nightmare trying to edit footage where somebody's answers are, also from the interviewee who's representing that company or that business or that story, it makes sure that they come across in a much more professional way, because the last thing you want is to put somebody in front of the camera who's stressed a bit. It's just, you remember, it should be a relaxed, easygoing process for everybody. The next tip is simple. It's about keeping it simple. I appreciate everybody's passionate about what they do and about their business, but we're not making Lawrence of Arabia here. I'm not trying to get a visual representation of Wikipedia. So, and this is where practicing the questions is so important, because As the interviewee, you can refine it down and get it down and down and down and down and down. So somebody says to me, Lee, what do you do for a living? I say, hi, well, my name's Lee Axon and I am Digifin. I'm a national and international full-time professional photographer, videographer, editor, and drone pilot. I primarily work in the corporate world. Basically, if it can be shot from the sky or the ground, that's what I do. I mean, I have practiced that, obviously. But that's the sort of thing I'm getting at. I'm not going to talk to you with that answer and say, well, you know, when I was 9 years old, you know, I picked up a camera, and then when I was 10, it's all about cost savings, effectiveness, and efficiencies. Keep it simple, keep it concise. Well, I hope you're getting something out of that. Even if you can take one hint or tip away to make your life easier, well, that's a benefit to us all, isn't it? If you have any comments or suggestions for me, please get in touch. All of my details are on my website and all of my contact details at the top of every page. If you are interested where we're at, where nose is pointing, see him. Weather's just changed since I arrived. However, I'm going to send the drone out there and I'll let you see what we can see. Great speaking to you. See you later. Bye-bye.